Monitor Dan Muller, and he has won 9 straight against the Evansville Purple Aces, and there you see the all-time series lead. And for Dan Muller, he's 15-4 all-time against the Purple Aces. As we take a look at the starting lineups, presentation of the Casey's General Store, set up for new Casey's Rewards, the rewards program that gives back by letting you redeem points, Casey's cash, fuel discounts, and donations to local schools. Underway, the Purple Aces looking for their first win in Valley play. They're on the road taking on the Illinois State Redbirds. Hope you enjoy it from Central Illinois. Aces coming off a tough loss over the weekend against Valparaiso. And Newton drains the triple and is fouled to start things off in the opening 20 seconds of this one.
Well, that's just being late getting out there and then not coming out under control. You can't give up a clean look at a three and commit the foul. And that was a touch foul. It was a foul, but you can't put yourself in that position. That's a great way to start for Evansville.
Jawan Newton coming off a career high 12 points in the loss against Valparaiso last weekend, picking up where he left off in that loss. A great second half, meanwhile, for Evansville in that game. And you know, Todd Licklider talking to him just briefly before tonight's game, trying to see if his team can kind of carry that momentum on the road here tonight against the Redbirds.
Dan Muller not happy. He felt his man inside was held, and that's why the pass was able to be stolen.
Speaking of steals, Zach right Copeland with a steal right there. Copeland has been on fire over the last couple of weeks. He is averaging over 21 points a game.
Yeah, I saw Copeland in the Bradley game I had. They played well. I mean, it's a tough matchup. Bradley's a really good team. They're at home, but he competes, Copeland. He really competes.
Coleman wide open, spots up for a triple, and off the mark. Rebound taken by J.C. Hillman. Here's Horn for three. Both of these clubs obviously struggling with their losing streaks at 8 for Evansville, 7 for Dan Muller's Illinois State Redbirds. It's been a while since the Redbirds have lost 7 straight, and for Dan Muller's, Cap pointed out a lot of injuries this season, especially to some key players, especially when he's had so many new faces into the program this year. Here's Cunliffe. He's been hot here of late for Evansville, and he drains the three as time expired on the possession clock.
Watch him if we get a chance to watch it again. He's ready to shoot it. Defender does a nice job, so he lets him fly right by, kind of like Maverick and Top Gun, and then re-racks himself with a dribble, gets back in rhythm, and buries a three.
I think we're just a few months shy of the Top Gun 2, right?
I can't wait.
With the triple, one of the two San Jose State transfers for Dan Muller's squad
Talking
this season. But back to what we were talking about earlier is the fact that Dan is frustrated because he says in spurts, his team plays really well, but he goes, Scott, we're just turning the ball over way too much right now.
When I talked to Dan, he said, you know, we'll have games, I'll put the tape on, I go, boy, we really rebound well. But man, we couldn't make a shot. Then I'll look at the tape and I'll talk to the team and go, we shot the heck out of the ball. Our rebounding was horrible. So we just got to put it all together.
Horn robbed there on that three attempt. Back the other way to the Aces.
You know, the amazing thing is, the Aces beat Kentucky earlier in the year. And you look at the struggles they've had, and you look at the talent on the Kentucky roster, you go, how did that happen?
Absolutely. No question about it. Well, really, you look at the numbers for Evansville, and they're impressive in non-conference play. They're averaging 78 points a game, 45% from the field, and since conference play has started, they're only averaging 55 points a game and 37% from the field. Shot clock winding down. Cunliffe trying to get some help. Coleman from the half court, basically, and oh man, that's going to go out of bounds off of Fisher, and it's going to be Aces basketball. So here's the other big loss when you talk about the other side. We talk about the battles of not scoring. Their leading scorer, DeAndre Williams, this guy can fill the cup up, Cap, and he's been out for a period of time.
And when you lose, you know, really good players, it just makes it so tough. Because now someone's not only got to fill that role, but who fills the role of the guy that filled that role? And you're always backfilling.
And we understand, talking to some of the Evansville people before tonight's game, that, you know, he is working diligently, DeAndre Williams, that is, to get back in the lineup. He just hasn't been given that medical clearance as of yet, but has been working real hard. And I know the Aces are optimistic that he can be in the lineup sooner rather than later. Hope a little bit off the mark on the left-hand lay-in. Reeves, the freshman from Chicago, in and out.
Zone defense out of Evansville.
Reeves for another three attempt.
They're doing a really nice job ball movement, forcing defenders to move, and they gave up another open look and another triple.
Well, when we talk about the turnovers, as Dan has alluded to us talking about his team, they actually had a game against Drake where they only had six turnovers against the Bulldogs. Nice jumper there by John Hall, the junior from Philadelphia.
Boy, somebody brought the shooting eye tonight. We're seeing threes rain down everywhere. Wholesale substitutions coming in for Evansville.
With the kick out. Dunliff off the front of the iron. Keith Fisher, the third, the freshman from Los Angeles, with the rebound. And Evansville basket
for turning it over at the most inopportune times, with 40 minutes of focus. That's Todd Licklider. I actually knew Todd in his previous life at Butler.
And then that was a pretty good life for him.
Really good life. And let me just tell you, it's not often when you have to make a coaching change during the season that in your own community you've got an accomplished guy with ties throughout the state that you're in. That's a great hire, man. To be able to get Todd Licklider, that is a home run hire for the administration at Evansville.
And
home run.
BC Coach of the Year during his years at Butler, of course. Two Sweet 16 appearances during his days.
And the funny thing is, if you ask Todd when he was just getting ready to leave Butler, he got mad at me one day. I said something he didn't like on a broadcast, and he was not happy with me. And I said, hey man, I'm just trying to tell the truth, what I believe, but you're a heck of a coach. And to see him back there at Evansville now, I think that's a really great hire.
I agree. No question about it. By the way, that two-pointer there by Hillsman, that's just the third two-point attempt in the opening six-plus minutes of this one. We've had 16 three attempts and just three attempts inside the arc here in the opening minutes.
See, the other thing about making a mid-season coaching change, bringing a guy in, albeit he was an assistant last year, but still in all, he hasn't had a, you know, training camp, so to speak,
right,
put his stuff in. It's just, guys, we're going to try and refine what you're doing, and we'll put our own stuff in after the season.
Reeves, nice fadeaway there for Tony Reeves. And I know Dan Muller would like to see this young man heated up. That would be huge, especially with the loss of Matt Chastain for at least 3 weeks with his knee injury. Nice entry, and a foul is going to be on the Redbirds.
Really good job to bounce pass through traffic, find your man, and he's going to get himself free throw. That's a really good pass. And Reeves was just a click late getting over there with his help side defense.
Reeves, the freshman, picks up the foul. Peace Ilagoma, junior from Nigeria, and a transfer from Pitt at the charity stripe. See more minutes here over the last couple of games for the Aces. Fisher posting up at the block, and it'll drop in the foul.
Really good job to get this ball down on the block. Good entry pass. See the seal? That is just an outstanding job at getting a seal, pinning the defender on the backside, and then the pass has to be on time and on the money, and they're going to get a three-point opportunity. Really good job by Fisher.
Sorry, Cap. Redbirds starting to feel it a little bit more here at home. They were one for their first six shooting, now five for their last six. Offensive rebound. Copeland for three.
Super defense on the perimeter.
Yep. Super. Riley on the drive. Short. Rebound taken by Injai.
Well, that was just outstanding perimeter defense to short circuit the offensive opportunity by Boyd. Over the top.
Yep. Injai's going to pick up the foul, as that is the third team foul on Illinois State early on.
There's the miss. That's just a clear foul. Over the top. Four. Go the other way.
A brief time, Cap, that I did get a chance to talk to Coach Licklider, I said, you're trying to, it's kind of hard, as you were mentioning, to implement something because you're
Very.
At midseason, even though he has a familiarity with most of these kids being with the team as an assistant last year. I said, do you actually look at some tape from other teams, or are you just trying to implement more of your stuff? And I think he's really just trying to get this team to get some positivity, if you will, with this club. Okay. And there's a goaltender.
Yeah, it's just so hard. For example, when I coached, I'll tell you about after the break.
Redbirds and Aces from Redbird Arena. It's the Valley on ESPN. Why don't we take a look at our Missouri Valley Conference standings. A presentation of Perina Dog Chow, crafted in the USA by people who care, with high quality ingredients. That's the Dog Chow promise. Actually, midway mark after tonight's games all across the Missouri Valley Conference. And we normally don't see this here, Cap. Illinois State at the bottom of this list. That's not what has happened under the Dan Mullen era.
No, Dan is an outstanding coach. His kids play hard. He is a good recruiter. He loves Illinois State. He was a two-time defensive player of the year in the Valley as a Redbird. He's got everything you could possibly want. Just one of those years with injuries, banged up in the top of the league. Northern Iowa's outstanding. Loyola's really, really good. It just makes it tough. What I was going to tell you is, when I coached, we ran what we called scoreboard. And so our point guard would come across half court, he'd give a glance. If it was an odd number that we had scored, we ran one set of plays. If it was an even number, we ran another set of plays. And then there were times we would flip that because we didn't want to be too predictable to our opponent.
Right.
We didn't know if the Astros were playing against us. So that makes it
tough.
It only
took 8 minutes for that reference.
Exactly. It makes it tough. You know, it's got to become second nature. Wow, that's just, the bank is open late night tonight, normally.
Definitely. Hall posting up. Kick out, three. Oh,
dang.
Beautiful. Fredericking drains the triple.
A really nice job to get his feet set and get a really good, clean look.
Copeland.
Well, we're going in these spurts, and then couple minutes, both teams struggled to get a really good shot opportunity, and now we're seeing really good action to get open opportunities.
Yeah, I really like the motion from the Redbirds on the offensive side of things. Nobody's standing around. Hall? No.
You hear Fisher, you can hear him in our headsets calling for the basketball. Hey, hey, hey! He had a good post again, a good seal. Just couldn't quite get the ball to him.
Redbirds coming off a tough loss last weekend against Southern Illinois, where the Saluki Dogs only had 17 points in the first half, which was the 11th lowest that the Redbirds have given up in a half in a long time.
Near steal.
Yep. From the outside, a little strong, and rebound taken four by the Aces. And the drive and the bucket. Shamar Gavance with the bucket.
You had a gamble to try and come up with the steal, and when you don't come up with the steal, now we call it jailbreak. Everything is breaking down, and bodies are all over the place, and it just parted in the middle of the lane. He did a really good job. Take it right to the rim, and he got a ticky-tack foul, and it's a three-point opportunity.
Zach Copeland is whistled for the infraction. That is his first foul of the evening. So we're tied at 19 at the 9:38 mark of our opening half. Hillsman trying to post up, kick out. Copeland now finds Fisher. A little strong, weak side rebound for the Aces. Aces winning the game on the boards, at least, against the Crusaders and Valparaiso in their loss on Sunday. Dumped down to Coleman. Whoa, nice spin move there by Evan.
Yeah, really nice pass inside, and DJ Horn was just half a second late. You got to play that by seeing your guy, seeing the other guy, seeing where the ball is, and you got to read it and be there to prevent that lay-in.
Hillsman from the outside, and it is a three-pointer for J.C. Hillsman. Lubinowitz lost the handle. Copeland on the break. Fisher catches up with it. Now they'll set up their half-court set. Fisher on Hall. Fisher with the left hand. Boy, Evansville doing a nice job on the defensive glass.
Well, yeah, one and done.
Lubinowitz. Oh, nice. And the timeout is taken. 7:33 remaining in our opening half, and the visitors have the two-point lead. Evansville leads it 24-22.
Knighted the Redbirds offense. We're seeing a lot of points here so far.
Yes, we are. Absolutely. Meanwhile, Hillsman and the Redbirds just with one turnover so far through the first 12-plus minutes. That, I know, has to please head coach Dan Muller. Fisher. Boy, he's strong inside, isn't he?
He is. What I really like, and we talked about it a little bit ago, Scotty, is he really posts well. He knows how to get a seal. Now it's up to his teammates to get the basketball to him.
Boy, Boy, Evansville really works the clock on these half sets, aren't they? Half court sets. It's basically down to single digits on virtually every possession they have, Cap.
Yep, and you get a foul here. It's called advantage-disadvantage, and Tom O'Neill, the official, all over that call. He saw the two guys locked up. One's extending his arm to hold the other man off. Going to get called every time.
Tom O'Neill, as Cap mentioned, along with Zelton Steed and Jeff Campbell, are our
officials. That's Tom O'Neill right there. Tonight is his 3,286th college game that he's officiated. And he said, yeah, that's a cool stat. He goes, I'm prouder to have three sons all officiating in Division I. Pretty cool.
He did tell us that.
He's a great guy.
You've known him for a long time.
I've known Tommy over 30 years, and I had a game once where we're both looking at each other. The two teams are fighting in the stands. He's looking at me like, they want me to go in there and break that up? I'm like, well, I'm not.
Hall hits the three for the Aces. Fisher again posting up. Lost the handle. And the scramble, and here come the Aces. Shamar Gavance from Toronto, Ontario, Canada. And shot clock down to single digits as the shot is taken, and a weak side rebound for Hillsman.
Much better defensive possessions for Illinois State. They've done a really good job limiting open looks.
Hillsman this time misses his first three attempt. It doesn't drop in this opening half. Shot clock at five. Pick and roll. Reeves is fouled. Boy, not only a patient offense, but again, credit the Redbirds defense as well, Cap.
Yeah, again, if you go back and watch that possession, Dan Muller's going to go, guys, that's how we defend. They're contesting everything. If the pass is skipped across, they rotate quick. They get out, pressure the ball. They don't give up an open shot. They know the shot clock's running down. They don't foul, and they end up forcing a turnover. Again, very, very good.
Hillsman high off the glass. And again, one and done on that possession for the Redbirds. Hall, wide open three.
Ooh, nice. Book it. Book it. Just as we were praising Illinois State's half-court defense, they gave up a wide-open look, and Evansville has stretched it out to a six-point lead on the road here.
Their largest of the evening here at Redbird Arena. And it looks like Frederick King will pick up the foul, the junior from Oakville, Illinois. Hillsman to the line, 74% from the charity stripe this season for the Redbirds. As we mentioned, one of two transfers from San Jose State, where he started in 13 games when he was at San Jose State. Meanwhile, his teammate there, Keith Fisher, also the transfer, started 30 games for San Jose State. Copeland will pick up his second foul of the half.
Don't know about that foul. I think he just dribbled right into the defender.
3:47 remaining in our opening 20 minutes. Evansville right now with the lead on the road by five. statefarm.com. We will have our Arch Madness profile with Sam Cunliffe, as well as our first half recap and the first half stats with Dave Kaplan. It's all coming up in our State Farm Halftime Report. Captain Scott Warman with you. Here it's the Valley on ESPN, and these two teams, well, they're battling out looking for their first win in a while. It's a seven-game losing streak for Dan Muller's Illinois State Redbirds heading into action here tonight. And again, as we mentioned, for the third coach of the season, Todd Licklider taking things over. Eight-game losing streak as the Purple Aces looking for their first win in Valley play. As we'll get to the midway point after tonight's games, I should say plural, in the Valley. That foul, by the way, right before we went to the break was on Njai, not Copeland. So Njai has two fouls. Copeland still
with
one.
That's when I was questioning the foul. I'm like, how could Copeland have picked up that foul?
Wow, Cunliffe from downtown.
Jeez.
Holy smokes.
I mean, that is a bomb. 8-point lead, Evansville.
Stepped right into it. Aces are 8 for 14 from beyond the arc in this opening half, Cap.
Right, as good as we've seen some possessions defensively, they've given up some pretty open looks here from three, and I'm curious to hear what Dan Muller says when I interview him after halftime.
Copeland with the answer.
Cunliffe immediately points to himself. It's my fault. I did not get out there on the shooter.
KJ Riley doing a nice job of backing in. Dan Muller again in his eighth season. 145 and 110 in his career as the head coach. Dan Muller, of course, one of the all-time greats in Redbird history. Those great teams back in the late 90s.
Cunliffe with another jump shot along the baseline. Manufactured points on a baseline out-of-bounds play. It's good coaching.
Cunliffe shooting over 40% from the field in five of the last eight games for the Aces. Copeland. And again, Aces slowing it down offensively as they have the 7-point lead on the road.
I'd get the ball to Cunliffe. That guy's been hot.
Agree. Riley off the back of the iron. Here's Torres, the Wichita State transfer. Horn from long distance.
Just what the doctor ordered for the Redbirds. You get really no movement out of the Evansville offense at the other end. You miss a long shot, it's a run out the other way, and you bury a triple.
We've had 33 attempts in this opening half. 30.
Fun to watch.
Yes, it is. Turnover by the Aces. That is their eighth of the evening. Last touch by Evansville. ISU has the basketball with 22 ticks remaining on the possession clock.
Well, here he comes along the baseline, tries to thread a needle. Lucky that ball's not turned over and stolen.
More nice head fake and the finish.
And all of a sudden, from an 8-point game, it's a 2-point game, and all the momentum has gone Illinois State's way here the last 3-4 minutes.
Ball cut off at the baseline, does a nice job on the pull-up. That erases a 6-0 run by the Redbirds. Hall already in double figures tonight. Cunliffe pulls down the miss. And And now the first half timeout is burned by Todd Licklider and the Evansville Purple Aces. There's an 8-second discrepancy between the shot clock and the game clock, as right now Evansville holding on to a 37-33 lead and trying to head into the locker room at the half with a lead on the road. Meanwhile, for Dan Muller's team, trying to get a stop here and trying to get some points on the board before we wrap up the opening 20 minutes of play here at Redbird Arena. Dan's squad, and we've seen it, even though we've seen the slow pace of the half-court offense by Evansville in the opening half, Dan's offense, one of the best, in fact, the best as far as opponents' possessions on the offensive end, is teams are averaging about 19.3 seconds per possession before they shoot the basketball. That's one of the things that Dan did on the floor for his many 4 years at Illinois State and carries it on as a head coach to his troops here in Central Illinois. See if the Redbirds can get a stop. Copeland with the steal. Hillsman, bucket and the foul. 6.8 remaining in our opening half. Take a look at this once again as Copeland decides to give up the shot. Sees Hillsman driving the lane, and JC's had a huge first half for Illinois State. Gets the bucket and will try to complete the three-point play and make it a one-point deficit here late in the first half. Nice job by JC. More than enough time. Riley gets the bump, puts it up, and that'll do it. 20 minutes in the books here at Redbird Arena, and right now Evansville has the lead at 37-36. That's the Dog Chow Promise. Back at Redbird Arena and our halftime report, a presentation of State Farm. Talk to an agent today. Brought to you by Casey's General Store. Sign up for new Casey's Rewards, the rewards program that gives back by letting you redeem points for Casey's cash, fuel discounts, and donations for local schools. Second 20 minutes getting set here at Redbird Arena. Aces and Redbirds, and Illinois State with the opening possession here in the second 20 minutes here. Cap.
Yeah, talking with Todd Licklider, it just feels like Evansville's got to do a better job trying to take care of the basketball. He felt, you know, you heard of too many home run opportunities. Just make the safe pass and live to fight another day. That's got to be their mentality. For Illinois State, I would attack inside. I go right at them.
9 turnovers, by the way, in the opening half for Evansville, which produced 9 points for Illinois State. There you see Zach Copeland, and he has had a monster last couple of weeks for the Redbirds as he hit the triple to get us started in the second 20 minutes of play. Shot clock at 3. Cunliffe. Horn.
Wow, hanging in the air. That's a really good start for Illinois State. All of a sudden, a 5-0 run. You force the turnover, and you feel like, okay, guys, we got our legs under us. Now we've got to really try to choke them off here in the half court.
Let's see if the Aces have an answer here. At 1, and oh, a foul on Horn right before a shot clock violation.
That one just drives you crazy as a coach, and it's a foul. It's all about freedom of movement. You got a veteran officiating crew. In fact, we mentioned Tom O'Neill. He's worked 4 Final Fours. Zelton Steed has called some humongous games. So this is a veteran crew, but they're under a mandate. It's freedom of movement. If you're going to impede someone's progress dribbling, you're going to get called.
6 of 8 Valley contests for the Aces heading into tonight's game. The Aces have had 10 or fewer assists. They had 11 in the first half of play. So doing a better job of sharing the basketball. Riley cut off, spins, too strong.
Yeah, that's not a really good shot opportunity. Not a real good shot opportunity. Really good defense again by Illinois State.
Copeland. And one and done. We have not seen Illinois State get very many offensive rebounds, much less opportunities, as there's a block there by Illinois State in transition. Hillsman. Cunliffe comes away with it.
Yeah, Redbirds are shooting a little quick for me here early. If you get a real good opportunity, go, but the first guy down that's open, pulled and fired, I would like to see them get everyone a touch. It's early second half. Let's see what we can get out of our offense. Go inside.
Oh, beautiful play. Coleman to Cunliffe.
Much needed for Evansville.
Very
much,
much so.
Needed.
Worked to perfection, too. Nice pass into Fisher, and he gets
beautiful.
The finish.
See, go inside. You've got a size advantage. You're playing here at home where you feel a little more comfortable. You got this team on the ropes. Dive it inside.
Three by Gavance is off the mark. Copeland. Looks like they're trying to give him more touches at least early on in this second half. It's been red hot, as we mentioned, over the last couple of weeks for the Redbirds. All ball, out of bounds, last touch by the Aces, so there's 5 remaining on the shot clock.
Yeah, just not a real productive possession. You look at some of the passes. Injai catches one, wants no part of it, and hands it right back. They go to the corner and really don't have a good, clean look and nearly turn it over. Run something where you can dive it into Fisher on the low post, and then he can either kick it out for an open look or he can take it to the basket, or you can kick it out and refeed the post.
Fisher, time winding down, and it goes the other way. Evansville basketball when we come back. Nice little give and go here. Coleman to Cunliffe, but
up 29 for the season from 3 coming in. And he's 3 of 5, and all of those are open looks. That does not make a guy whose defensive philosophy comes first in Dan Muller, 2-time defensive player of the year as a player here at Illinois State, does not make him happy.
Evansville, by the way, they shot over 50% from the field and beyond the arc in the opening half. The last time they did that was back on December 21st in a matchup against the Racers of Murray State. Jai doing a nice job on the defensive end on the glass. Oh, man. On the drive, and he tried to hand it off to Fisher, and he goes off his fingertips in a turnover for Illinois State.
Yeah, Horns saying to Zelton Steed, the official, hit me on the elbow and I lost possession. We'll see if he does indeed get hit. And that's where, as he was letting it go, defender put his hand there. I really didn't see much of a foul.
But Cap, that's just the 3rd turnover of the evening for Illinois State. Good ball rotation. Cunliffe, wide open 3.
Boy. You get him a chance to set his feet, he catches it, and he is beautiful with the elbow in, the shoulders over toes, and let's go get him.
3 of 5 from beyond the arc. The answer for the Redbirds inside.
And that's, for me, that's what I'm doing every time down.
Absolutely, I agree. Whoa, nice little backdoor. Cunliffe will let it slide in, and I think some of the folks here at Redbird Arena thought maybe there was a goaltending, and Dan Muller pleading this case with Tommy O'Neill.
Yeah, Dan Muller saying that's offensive basket interference. I couldn't tell from where we are. I'd have to see a replay.
Man, Reeves from way downtown. Wow, how about a hole running the floor and the flush? And
beautiful
the Aces
job.
Take the lead, Cap. 46-45. Fisher.
Offense. So was it basket interference or not? Let's take a look. No, I don't think that's
not
in
all.
Any way offensive basket interference. I thought that was just a heck of a play.
Absolutely.
To bat it up into the hoop.
Talk about some athleticism. Oof. Cunliffe is impressive, no doubt about it. Jay Riley directing traffic. Oh, found a little bit of a seam. Nice drive to the basket.
Well, just broke the defender down. Nobody rotated over to take the lane away. He did a heck of a job to finish that play up off the backboard. You watch him with the dribble and see how nobody rotates over? That's just a really good, that's a man making a play.
Big quarter, there's no question. And now Riley. Try to complete the three-point play here.
All of a sudden, it's a four-point lead for Evansville, and they've steadied their sea legs here in the start of the second half.
Riley goes to the lane a lot, I should say the free throw line a lot this season. 7-0 run right now for the Aces, which is now finished off as Ray Adoru with the bucket and the foul.
But again, good job, Illinois State. Go back inside. It's a good job. Power it up, finish. Body is draped on him, and three-point play opportunity.
Coleman picked up the foul. That is his third personal for the Aces. Riley again going right to the rack. Holy smokes.
That is going to drive Dan Muller crazy. He goes, guys, for all the good plays we make defensively, boy, we have breakdowns.
And yeah. And Frederkeen's going to pick up the foul here.
Yeah, Frederkeen saying, I didn't foul him. He tripped. But I think there's some backside contact right there. And that's what put Adowu on the deck.
It's Frederick's second, and Coleman checks out as he has 3 fouls. John Hall back into the game for the Purple Aces. Torres, the Wichita State transfer, gets the deuce. Aces 5 for the last 5 from the field. Hey, if they're going to give it to you, might as well take it, right, Cap?
Exactly.
Hillsman in transition, and he'll head to the free throw line.
It's funny that you put it that way. Kyle Shanahan, they asked him, you're his offensive guru. Why did you only throw 8 passes in the NFC title game? And he said, because it's working. Run the ball.
Right.
They're not going to stop it. And it's the same thing, same
exactly.
principle here. If I can get myself to the rim, why would I not continue?
You're going to continue to give me those high percentage shots. Why not?
I'm now, taking them.
Here's what's going to happen is now Illinois State's going to clamp down and he can have some wide open threes on some kickouts.
Correct. I always say to you, the best way to a clean perimeter look is through the interior, in, out.
Right. Dunlap comes back in for Evansville.
Beautiful Doug Collins court. I talked to Doug the other day. It's such an honor to have a court named for him.
Absolutely.
And he was a great player here out of Benton, Illinois. And I believe, did you know his high school classmates, I think, or college classmates were D.A. Wybring, the golfer, and John Malkovich.
No kidding. I had no idea
yes.
about that. Redbirds with an opportunity to regain the lead on this possession. Hillsman for three.
Book it. Big three for the Redbirds. They go back in front by three.
Seventh lead change here tonight. 7-0 run right now for the Redbirds. Hinowitz high off the glass.
Tough play to try and complete there.
Copeland spots up for a three.
But Cunliffe wanted that shot, too.
He did.
Got numbers for Illinois State.
Reeves drains the three. Reeves. 57-51 as we near the midway mark of this second half of play. What a run right now for the Redbirds as they have their largest lead of the night. Officials timeout right now. And Zelton Steed blew the whistle. And it looks like he's talking to a couple of guys, maybe getting a little physical inside, and we'll take a break. It's 10:27 remaining in the second half here at Redbird Arena. Right now, the Birds on a 10-0 run, and they take the lead for Dan Miller. March Madness, yeah, there's nothing like it. And the road to the Final Four goes through St. Louis. The 2020 NCAA Men's Basketball first and second rounds, March 19th and 21st at Enterprise Center, hosted by the Missouri Valley Conference. Visit ncaa.com/MBB tickets and get your seats today. Take a look at the action. Full slate of games in the Valley. We already have three finals as Christian Williams gets the game winner at the buzzer for Indiana State at home, knocking off Drake. Bradley wins big at home against Valpo. How about the Northern Iowa Panthers?
They're awesome. They just keep rolling on, and I am a huge fan of Ben Jacobson. That guy can flat out coach. And Loyola struggling with Southern Illinois.
Yeah.
And we had that game back
we
up
did
at Loyola.
A couple weeks ago. And it, very impressive. Brian Mullen's team, of course, pulling away the victory against Illinois State last weekend. And a lot of people have picked Southern to be in last in the preseason poll. Brian taking things over and only a couple of guys returning. In fact, Aaron Cook out for the rest of the year. That was announced after we had that game a couple of weeks ago, and they're still fighting and battling. Brian Mullen's putting together a nice freshman season as the head coach at Southern Illinois. Meanwhile, for Northern Iowa, A.J. Green, 27 points in the nearly 30-point win against Missouri State.
Crowd doesn't like the call. They thought it went off of Evansville. The official said it went off of Illinois State, and it will stay Purple Aces ball.
Kick out. And Frederickine hits the three.
And where did the three come from? Right through the interior, kick it to a spotted up shooter.
Just what you were talking about moments ago.
Well executed, well done.
Fisher on Hall. Nice, strong move. Fisher. Boy, I like Fisher's game.
Strong, long arms, he's active. See how hard Fisher works? That's a, you know, just, that's a making a play. That's a tough shot. I thought Fisher gave you good effort there, really did.
It's interesting how Evansville here in the second half, after having so much success beyond the arc, has kind of put on the brakes with those long range jumpers. Fisher does it once again.
Yep.
Back and forth we go.
Missed the shot, doesn't quit on the play, goes right back up and tips it home.
Reeves pulls away with a long rebound for Illinois State.
Illinois State needs to run their offense and get the ball inside. Don't need the first open quick shot. What do I know?
I wasn't going to say anything, but.
As soon as I said it, I went, he's going to drill this.
You can see it all the way.
But if I'm running the tape back, I'm going, guys, that's not a good shot.
Right. If it's anybody else than Zach Copeland, then I think you're exactly right. Dan Mueller would have had a serious problem with that.
No doubt.
But the Missouri Valley Conference is the second oldest Division I athletics conference. To learn more about the storied history, visit the Valley Runs Deep landing page at mvcsports-sports.com/the-valley-runs-deep. Reggie Redbird and the Illinois State fans happy right now at Redbird Arena as they have the lead at 64-56 as we are under 8 minutes left looking for their first win and trying to break a seven-game losing streak. The Catman, Dave Kaplan, Scott Warman with you. It is the Valley on ESPN here this evening from Central Illinois. As showed you the scores earlier, five games, a full slate here tonight, and that means after tonight all teams will have hit the midway mark of this Valley season. Timeout on the floor, 7:52 remaining.
Before I go to work at Dog Chow, I promised Maggie the chicken that goes in the Dog Chow is farm-raised American chicken, and that every bag of Dog Chow meets high-quality standards. That's the Dog Chow promise.
Now in high-protein wet recipes.
Introducing a hotel carefully crafted to leave a vivid imprint in downtown St. Louis. Designed with an effortless sense of style. Experience the luxury of Hotel St. Louis. Hotel St. Louis. Exactly like nothing else.
The 30th anniversary of Arch Madness tips off March 5th through 8th in St. Louis. And the only place to celebrate before and after all the action at Enterprise Center is the MVC Fan Hangout at Ballpark Village. The MVC Fan Hangout is the ideal place showcasing a diverse offering of restaurants, entertainment, and nightlife attractions. All the fun starts 2 hours before the first game every day of the tournament. So make plans to visit the MVC Fan Hangout during Arch Madness 30. See you there.
Beans is like a child for me. So every time I go to work at Dog Chow, I promise to use quality ingredients that I'm proud of, like American raised chicken from farms right here in the USA. For Beans and for all dogs, that's the Dog Chow promise.
Hey, reminder, join us next Wednesday, February 5th, for more men's basketball action with the Valley on ESPN as the Missouri State Bears will play host to these Illinois State Redbirds at JQH Arena in Springfield, Missouri. Exclusive coverage gets underway at 7 Central. It's the Valley on ESPN. Well, Dave Kaplan, Illinois State went to with a much stronger performance in this second half, hence the 8-point lead and really working the ball to Mr. Fisher inside.
Yeah, and I said to you early, they've got to go inside, because if you go inside, now you force the defense to shift. They're going to have to double him, going to have to attack him, and then he can kick it back out. You can refeed the post to get him a layup. You can kick it back out and get another 3-point opportunity. You don't need the first pass across and let's take the three. And I think Dan Muller impressed upon his guys. Guys, we're going to start at the defensive end, but then let's get the ball inside and see if we can make some hay. We're bigger and we're stronger, and they've done a really good job with that.
Riley open inside, the bucket and the foul.
Good pass. Really good pass by Kuhlman. Really good pass.
It's really interesting to me. Again, 15 three attempts by Evansville in the first half. Todd Licklider goes into the locker room at the half, and there's so much concentration kept with this team getting more of the high percentage points inside.
Yeah, they're not a great shooting team. That's just who they are. So if I'm Illinois State, I want to know where Cunliffe is at all times. I still don't buy what Hall was selling in the first half, 2 for 29. I'm just speaking from a coach's perspective.
Sure.
2 for 29, even though he was 3 for 5 in the first half, I'm still going to believe you're more the 2 for 29 guy. And so I'm going to take Cunliffe away, and then I'm going to dominate you inside. That's what I'm going to try to do.
Frederickine on the drive, too strong, one and done. Here come the Redbirds. Reeves in transition, and he'll head to the charity stripe with 6:59 remaining.
What a really outstanding pass in transition. This is not an easy pass. To put a little English on it, bounce it between the defenders. Watch this pass. Okay, there's the miss. Now let's get it, let's go. That pass to get it right by Cunliffe, that is an outstanding job.
Nice job by the freshman. Cunliffe from downtown, way off the mark.
Yeah, that was shot clock running down. He didn't really have a choice.
Nice pass by Copeland. Holy smokes. Terrific ball rotation on that possession.
That's a gold star. If I'm Dan Muller, man, that gets me fired up. Look at the ball movement. That is exactly what I'm looking for as a coach.
Now the Aces, which have concentrated more of the high percentage shots, might have to start thinking about threes here shortly. Reeves, dish off, in jive.
Yeah, you got to get a timeout here, Evansville. Getting a little disjointed. Too many guys standing around watching Riley dribble the basketball. And that's why things are going to break down.
7-0 run over the last nearly 90 seconds for Dan Muller's Illinois State Redbirds. And Todd Licklider, in his third game as the head coach at Evansville, burns that timeout.
Let's take a look at the last couple buckets. There's Injai inside. Good job to gather himself, head and shoulder fake, and then finish. And then watch the ball movement. Just spectacular ball movement. There's the open man. Boom. And Dan Muller pumps his fist. One knee comes up. He was excited.
So Hillsman with the three. That gives him 20 points, which is a season high for JC. And for Zach Copeland, that's his seventh assist tonight. And for Copeland, that ties a career high. Well, now I'm going to be intrigued as Licklider again talking it over with his troops, trying to put a stop to the 7-0 run for the Redbirds here in Normal, Illinois. Be intrigued to see if they have a few more three attempts here at the 5:31 mark, down by double figures. But you got to have the right guy shooting three. And it's kind of like Copeland on the one side for the Redbirds. You got to have at least Cunliffe, who's probably your best three-point shooter, on the other side.
Correct. But that, to get him an open look, because Illinois State's done a really good job denying him, you've got to move the ball. And there was too much standing around where Riley's got the ball and four other guys are watching.
Right.
I remember the late John McDougal, who I worked for, who's the winningest coach in Northern Illinois history. He used to yell, "Nobody bought a ticket to watch you dribble. Move the ball."
I love that. That's awesome.
It was great.
Evansville says that it was last touched by.
Yeah, I didn't think that it was. Let's take a look. There's the entry.
Nobody touched it.
It's a really tough pass to catch. You got to ask yourself, okay, who am I throwing it to? What can he do with it if he does catch it?
Well, they let him play on, and they're going to say Hillsman last touched it. Just a turnover. The fifth, only the fifth here tonight, Cap, for Dan Muller's squad. Off on the three attempts. Reeves from the corner.
Yeah, a little quick again
for
me.
I agree. There's Riley just going right to the basket once again, but a little strong on the attempt. Now Torres will slow it down.
Good decision by Torres. Wichita State transfer.
Redbirds shooting over 60% from the field in this second half. Five players in double figures for Dan Muller's squad. Fisher. Going up against Coleman, and it looks like Coleman's going to pick up his fourth foul.
So just a good physical play. Got it. Push in the back from the backside. When you put two hands on the dribble, you're going to get called every time. It's just an automatic.
Just the fifth team foul. Meanwhile, Illinois State only with four team fouls. Fisher lost the handle, but
got hacked.
Frederickson will pick up the foul. That'll be his third for Noah. With 13 points tonight for Illinois State. Biggest lead for the Birds now at 14 at 73-59. It's a 9-0 run right now for ISU. Attempts.
Another good decision.
Absolutely.
Pull it back out.
Perfect.
Clock drips under 3:30. Guys, we're up by 14 points. We don't need to shoot it quick.
quick hands, and Redbirds will retain possession when we come back as we head down the stretch here at Redbird Arena. Who's going to break their losing? A bit of a court awareness. He knows that his team's up big. He can take the shot. A lot of guys would do that, but he wants to kill more clock. Good
move.
Yeah,
you want your guys to start to become more perceptive as the season goes on. Of guys, we're 14 points up. We probably don't need to score again to win the game. So let's not first pass it across. I got an open look. Let me jack it. Because that's how you let a team climb back in the game.
All right, so 14 remaining on the shot clock for the Redbirds. Fisher.
Good defense inside.
Yeah,
really
Coleman.
Good.
Obviously, Evansville going to push it here.
Good steal, and there's a foul reach out. No question about it, intentional. Right call, right call. Tommy O'Neill, the veteran, all over it. There comes the steal right there, getting up in the passing lane, and you see the shirt get grabbed. No attempt to play the ball. It's an easy call. Two shots and the ball.
Fisher, 2 for 3 from the free throw line tonight.
Riley came over and said, what'd I do? He said, Tommy O'Neill said, you grabbed him. He goes, yeah, I did. Gotcha.
Obviously kept the big story around our country and around the world is the tragic death of Kobe Bryant. This young man actually from L.A. and speaking to some of the folks in the media this past week on obviously the tragedy of Kobe losing his life at such a very young age and, of course, sadly, his teenage daughter as well. And obviously Kobe meant a lot to not only him but so many young people across our land.
Just a horrific story. Horrific. I have a dear friend who lives in L.A. He's actually a private investigator there. We went to high school together. And he said his neighbor is in his 80s, and he said, I've seen it all. And this was more devastating to the city than when Robert F. Kennedy was assassinated in L.A.
Riley. Too strong. Fisher there for the rebound. Nothing but white jerseys. And Illinois State going to wind down this clock. And I can imagine right now that Dan Muller is just moments away from exhaling, to say the least.
Yep, got an 18-point lead. We're inside 2 minutes. He knows he's going home a victor tonight.
Shot clock violation, but all to no avail. I think Dan might have been looking to see if Copeland could have gotten a foul and gone to the free throw line.
He was saying something to the official, and I'm thinking, what are you saying?
He was working it pretty good, wasn't he?
He was. Well, you got an 18-point lead. What do you look angry for over there?
Exactly. Fredeking. And the three ball not dropping as much in the second half for the Purple Aces. That ended a 6-minute scoring drought cap for the Purple Aces. Called. All right, Cap, when we get to our players of the game, a presentation is State Farm. Talk to an agent today at 800 State Farm or by visiting statefarm.com.
Well, Cunliffe, I thought, played really well tonight. They did a good job on him in the second half at limiting his touches and opportunities. Still, 6 of 11 from the floor. He had 3 triples. And I thought Hillsman was outstanding tonight. 20 points, 6 of 9. knocked down threes when they needed them, when they were struggling in the first half. So I thought those two guys are the most deserving of our Player of the Game award.
Well, the Redbirds obviously feeling a little bit better about themselves after tonight's performance, especially in the second half. And as you pointed out, Cap, this has obviously not been the year that Dan Mueller or anybody had imagined with ISU, but such huge injuries to guys like Chastain and Berninga, who they really counted on for a lot of points and some of their top players heading into this season.
Yeah, and it makes it so tough when your perimeter game breaks down, because if you have those guys that are spotted up, it opens everything else up inside. It just makes you a different team.
Redbirds will take another shot clock violation. Meanwhile, for the Evansville Purple Aces, still in search for their first win in Valley plays. This will be just the third game for Todd Licklider as the head coach in Evansville. Riley with two more, and we will wind the clock down on this one, and the steal on the inbounds.
Crowd doesn't like it.
Smattering of boos at the end, and that'll do it. Illinois State finally stops the losing streak at seven as they knock off Todd Licklider's Evansville Purple Aces tonight, capped by a final of 77-66.
Yeah, that's just a good win for Illinois State. They needed a win badly. They're here at home.